Abby here. Welcome back to my channel for Tech Tuesday, or welcome if you're new. Today I'm going to be showing you the best DDR4 RAM for the Lenovo Legion Tower 7i desktop. But before I get started, make sure to hit that subscribe button. If you're not already subscribed, so you can stay tuned to all my new videos dropping weekly, and so you can help the channel grow. I got this PC about a year ago, and I have a full review on the Lenovo Legion Tower 7i, as well as an unboxing if you wanna check that out. And recently I wanted to upgrade my RAM just so I can do a bit more multitasking, kinda have a little bit faster rendering and stuff when I'm doing my editing for my videos. So I was looking into a bunch of different RAM options, guys. So this PC is definitely upgradable, but you do have to meet some of the specifications if you wanna get, you know, your advertised run speeds and if you want full compatibility with many components, especially with the RAM. So today I'm gonna show you a RAM that I found that meets all of this computer's specifications, it runs at the desired speeds, and it's affordable, guys. So here is the RAM that I got from Crucial, and I got this on Amazon. So it's a 32 gigabyte kit. It is DDR4, 3200 megahertz. It has 1.2 volts and it has a CL latency of 22. All right, so before you get started, make sure to ground yourself by touching an unpainted metal surface. For me, on mine, that's this part. So what we're gonna do next is I'm going to remove the current RAM I have in here, and then I'm gonna replace it with the Crucial RAM that I bought. So to take them out, so we're simply just gonna open up the latches at both ends here, one here and one here. And I'm gonna do that on both of them. And then I'm gonna pull it directly out. Here is the RAM that I have. It's the Kingston HyperX Fury. So it's a 32 gigabyte kit. And this is the most basic as basic RAM that you're going to find. It has no casing, no RGB, no cuteness. It's just straight up the interior. Basically this one looks like that. Inside it just has a case. As you could see, there's green peeking out. So now I'm just gonna put it in. I'm just gonna put it in the exact same slots again, slots 2 and 4. So I'm just gonna line it up. And then I'm going to take two hands and apply firm pressure on both sides until you hear a click. And now I'm gonna do the exact same thing with the other one. Once again, I'm putting this one in slot 4. And once again. And here it is installed. It is that easy, guys. So now I'm gonna go ahead and put the glass back on. It's best to start your PC with this on so you're not getting any additional dust in it. So guys, I just wanna let you know that I have tried so many different types of RAM with this PC. I've tried two different ones from Corsair, the Corsair Vengeance, LPX, the RGB. I've tried a Kingston Fury. These didn't work. This is the fourth one I'm trying right now, the Crucial. Now I'm gonna go ahead, plug my PC back in and get it started. When I did this previously with the other ones, it did take a little bit longer than usual, the first startup after installing RAM. So I'm just showing you guys the monitor right now. It is still loading, so it's definitely taking longer than usual. If you guys watched my review of this PC, I did time the start time initially in that video. This is definitely taking longer. So it's finally going. Definitely taking about maybe 20 seconds longer than usual. And it's signed in. So now we're gonna go over here to our task manager. Going over to performance, we can see our CPU, memory, disk, all this stuff. I'm gonna go over to memory. We are getting that 3200 megahertz speed. So we're getting the advertised, you know, speed for this RAM. And not only that, we are seeing the gigabytes. So 26.9 available out of the 30, which is normal. You know, a bunch is in use for computer things. And when I tested out the Corsair, guys, I was getting 2400 megahertz when it was supposed to be 3600. So I'm happy that this is working at the advertised speed here. So if you guys have this PC, the Lenovo Legion Tower 7i, and you're looking to boost up your RAM, definitely go ahead and get this one. I have a link in the description for you, and just make sure that you are getting the same model. You know, here is the model number once again. So that's all I have for today, guys. And if you did find this helpful, definitely go ahead and give me a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel because I'm dropping new tech videos every Tuesday. Thanks for watching, guys. Make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. Bye.